Our bionic kids have all told a similar story. When they would go to the grocery store without wearing an arm, people would come up to them and say, "What's wrong with you? Why are you broken?"
They once said these, "I lost it in the war," and a shark ate it.
When they're wearing a really expressive, beautiful, artistic arm, the questions completely change. Instead, people come up to them and they say, "How does that work? Where did you get it? That's so cool. How do I get one for myself?"
This clinical trial really is the first of its kind. We are looking at examining the next generation of 3D printed prosthetics for children born with congenital limb loss. And approximately 1 in 1,500 children are affected with this. Our goals really for the project are to examine the functionality, the acceptability, and also really the psychosocial benefits that I think will be present for the children receiving these arms.
Our goal with the clinical trial is to really gather the data to be able to showcase how well the arm is working, obviously where it needs to improve, and to be able to take that data and show the FDA that 3D printed electromyographic arms are ready for kids.
Oh yeah, oh this is super cool. So in this bag, we got our brand new prototypes. So this is what our new prototypes look like. What do you think?
This device is a myoelectric arm. And we have EMG sensors on here, so electromyography sensors, that you would put on the lowest muscle group that you have. Not only when you flex, it not only opens and closes the hand, you flex at 30%, it opens and closes, but if you flex at 60%, you can get a different gesture out of it. Other functionalities of this arm is that you can actually take off the covers and you can actually replace them with different covers. They're magnetically clipped on. This one also has the ability to grab around an object much better, much cleaner. And it has these little pieces of silicone on here on the fingers in order to help grip.
Up until this point, it's wonderful to build these devices and to deliver them, but it's another thing to make sure that the children are successful with them. And that's the expertise that OHSU is bringing. The clinical supervision, as well as the proper training and therapy that's involved for the children to be truly successful with the devices.
It has a huge long-term effect on the goals that they'll set, how comfortable they are going to school and thereby studying really hard. And that's what we're trying to encourage, is to give them the tools, not only for their daily tasks, but to give them that expression and confidence so that they'll chase all their dreams and really become anything that they can imagine.